Hi, this is Metal Steve again. I was having some trouble. I couldn't understand what was going on with my Saxon album. I couldn't place what was up with it today. Look. Look at the S. No way, it gets better. It gets better, folks. Look, it's upside down. You know what that means? Saxon is now written on the bottom of the CD. See? The bottom.
I've never seen that before. Speaking of IMI,
J.I.M.I. Hendrix. I think they're trying to tell us something. That just happened. What do you think? You always seen that A like that? Always seen that A like that? What about J.I.M.I. Hendrix? I.M.I., huh? What about the name Linda, spelled like Lynn? Remember that? L-Y-N-D-A. What about Jennifer with a G? What about I Dream of Jeannie with two N's? Wouldn't that make it Jenny now? The way Jennifer's spelled? The Scorpions. What about Living Color? Oh wait, never mind, that's supposed to be color. What about Jekyll, spelled like the band Jackal? J-E-C-K-Y-L. Like J-A-C-K-Y-L. What about that play on words? Where'd that go? Anybody remember Megadeth being written like this? Caps,
Megadeth.
Anybody remember that? I don't. Like he's shouting Megadeth, all caps. I remember a little more metal font on Megadeth. What do you remember? No way, I have one last one.
Look how giant's written.
That doesn't say giant, does it? It says C-A-S-H. Cash for gas. Look at the way four is written. Look how four is written, cash for gas. This is a giant gift card. Where does it say giant? Look at the way four is written. F-O-R.
Cash for gas.
But this isn't a gas gift card, it's a giant gift card. Where's Giant? No, wait, I got a couple of these. From now until the film runs out or whatever. Got a couple of these.
Look, here's a picture of Superman. Here's a picture of Superman on my old MP3 CD. Look at that S on his chest. Is that what you remember? Do I have residual? For your memory? Butterfly. Look how Iron Butterfly is written. Iron Butterfly sounds different to me, too.
You think there's anything we can do about it?
Who remembers Aerosmith like this? Would be Toys in the Attic, wouldn't it? Don't you see? Toys in the Attic. 90s version. Rush. Spot anything yet? Struggle to gain, and happiness my friends never came. how Judas Priest is written. Boy, that's not how it was written on the 90s album. And yet, this is like the early 80s Priest label, look. But look, it's Painkiller. When did they go back to their 80s design on Painkiller? Well, there's an awful lot of blue up here. You recognize all that? You see, it says Painkiller. Now it says Priest here, though. Judas Priest. Look how it says Priest. Judas Priest. Interesting.
Look, here's proof something's up.
Here's the old Twisted Sister case. Interesting how that's written.
Now all you might remember these things.
Here's the Aerosmith first album with the different version of Dream On. Interesting. It's got the old Aerosmith on it, look. It's so faded though. It's got the old Aerosmith on there like crazy. So tiny and faded though now. Let's see if I can get this. So it's the old Aerosmith, the way it's written.
But it's got the year and tear on it. Look at the dark side of the moon.
I know this is the most recognized symbol almost in Pink Floyd history, but where's the title? I remember a title. I remember Pink Floyd, Dark Side of the Moon, under the symbol. Pink Floyd above, Dark Side of the Moon below. Wish I could show you guys what I remember.
Oh yeah, all these band members where I'm from, I keep looking all this stuff up, it's like, they died of apparent suicide. No, they died from apparently doing something stupid. They weren't thinking, so they accidentally killed themselves. And it's like all written down here as suicides. I don't understand that. There were some groups where I'm from that didn't like rock and roll, but there wasn't quite as much apparent to the suicide
where I'm from. I got one last thing to show you. This symbol. You remember this? Can you see this where my hand is? Remember that at all?
Still a good radio.
This one. This is still a really good radio.
But I think I have some residual here.
If I can zoom up on it, I think I have some residual here. If I can get it in the picture.
It's really dark.
I've seen some interesting Sony labels lately, but I think I have some residual here. S space rounded O space.
Down, slide, up, N, with the little N's on it. Holy smokes. Is it connected? Darn, I thought I had some residual. No way! Is it connected? Oh my God. Oh my actual God.
Oh my actual God. Don't tell me it's connected. S. O. N. Oh, thank God. It's a heck of a lot closer than I remember, though. You see that? No connected N and Y in Sony.
It's too darn close for comfort, though. I don't remember it being that close, but at least it's not connected. All the Sony stuff I've seen lately has, this is physical residual proof that N and Y weren't connected in Sony. I've seen a lot of Sony stuff, really old Sony stuff, with connected N's and Y's. A bunch of them. Ah, my radio's on. I wonder how long that's been on. Nah, not very much. I must have flipped it on by accident when I was trying to examine it. Yeah, the tape player died. The N and the Y are too darn close together for comfort, but they're at least not connected. And the tape player's out now, but the radio is still beautiful in that thing. I don't remember the Y practically. I don't remember the N and the Y going up to kiss like that. And I don't remember them connected. That's ridiculous. Alright. This is Metal Steve signing off. Hopefully you've gotten this. Actually, screw it. I'm going to... I'm going to show you what I mean by the Sony.
I'm going to show you what I mean by Sony. Boy, that up and happened. You see, that's the way it is now, and the way it's been. Straight on.
But that faded gray radio must have been from where I'm from, because A, it works. I don't remember that. At all.
What the hell? Look at the Walkman symbol. I didn't even think to look at that when I saw the other letters connect. That was tactile. This isn't. Let me see this. Oh my god, is that tactile?
Look at that! The Walkman symbol is raised!
I'm sorry, that was way too loud. That is black. It's turned black, and it's raised. Looks like double V's now with a short end. Look at that, it's raised. You can't make that up.
Wow. It's black. That's never been black. Unbelievable. That's never been black. Could the strange change have killed my Sony radio? Is that what's happening here? Because it's messed up now. It is absolutely sloppy now.
Look, you can see how old this radio is in the light. I'm done with this. I'm going to show you the symbol on here. See if you remember this. Here we go. Excuse me. You remember the symbol being like that? I mean, look at this. You remember that? Because I remember boing, not boing.
I remember the boing being out the bottom.
Look again. No, that wouldn't bump it into the dial. Look again. That wouldn't bump it into the dial. See? The way that shifts over. Well, if it was facing, well, if that end was facing down, it still wouldn't
bump it into the dial. But how is that possible? Look how old this radio is. It's from the 90s. And it's been torn apart by somebody who really liked to use it. Plus the CD player. Uh-oh. Plus the CD player came back. Are you actually seriously telling me the CD player came back on its own accord?
for no reason. One last one.
Look at this docking. Yes, I have docking albums. Yes, I actually have the best of docking. This isn't the first one. This is the best of docking. Look at the way Dawkins written. I don't remember those ends. I don't remember the D being quite shaped like that. I remember a more round, I remember a more squared off back of the D. I mean, it didn't look like this. Look how Dawkins written. I don't remember the bottoms on the K. Look, it's all connected too now. Wow.
It's all connected. It was... I wish I still had the old tape case, man. I could see whether it was connected on the tape case or not. Wow. Docking is all connected now. That just happened. Wow, that just... I don't even know. I don't even know, man. And there's one really neat one on Mom's stereo, too. She's got a CD changer made by Sony. S. Squared O. Wait. N. Yeah, squared O, N. Looks like the Y might be connected. No, it's barely separate. Wow, like my radio. It's barely separate like my radio. Interesting. But Mom's got a Sony TV here. S-O. Barely separate N-Y, too. Here. But this... This,
I don't know if you can see this or not. Has a completely square top, a completely straight top and bottom on the O and rounded sides. Right.
And our DVD player is a wonderful mess. So I'm looking for connected letters here real quick. Oh, yeah, it's covered in dust. I'm not going to be messing with that. Never mind. See if I can spot one of the speakers. The brand name on it. Oh, look.
It's the Sony that's on my little Walkman where it's all joined. This thing is a hot mess. Don't get it. We're using it because we got it as a gift. But this thing's a hot mess. This thing's a mess. It's thousands and thousands of dollars Sony DVD player.
Look at that. The thousands and thousands of dollars Sony set. That thing does not work right. And the Sony is all connected. Look at that. So the ones with the NY that are almost connected are the good ones, and the ones with the SONY all connected are the ones where you don't want to play with that. One last thing, if I can hold out. If my timer can hold out, I mean. Maytag. Our washer is a Maytag. The Y and the T. It's pronounced Maytag, but the Y and the T are the only connected letters. So it's Maytag. Now, M-A-Y-T-A-G, but the Y and the T form each other, Maytag, one word, but it's always been Maytag. Interesting.
See? See if I can get this. You know what I mean, though, right? You can look this up. Maytag. Yeah, I can't get this.
It's too dark in here. Hold on.
Yep, still not getting this, I don't think. Hold on. There we go. There it is. M-A-Y-T-A-G. M-A-Y-T-A-G. Y-T.
Maytag.
Yo, what the heck happened here? That doesn't even need explaining.
I'm sorry, man. That doesn't even need explaining. This is Metal Steve signing off. Later.